it's your favorite French YouTuber. And today's video is sponsored by Carpet Cleaner. My dog decided to take a sneaky little in the corner right over there without me finding out until this very moment. I'm like, why has this room been smelling like pee? And I found the pee. So you know, it's the holidays and everybody's out here spending a lot of money. But what about making a lot of money? We never talk about that. So if you're sitting at home wondering, what should I do? I need to get a job soon. I got you. Today I got some weird jobs for you that pay pretty good. Doesn't mean everybody wants to do them. Do you have what it takes to be a model? No? Are you a person that can stand up for long periods of time? Sure. Well, you can apply to be a live mannequin and they pay up to $100 an hour. All you gotta do is wear the clothes and stand in the store and not move. It's like the mannequin challenge. Y'all do it for free anyway. When I was a kid, I always wondered this. Like, can you just stand in the front of the store and pretend to be a mannequin? Legit would have been my dream job as a child. Okay, I can't believe this is a real thing. A professional bed warmer? Really? But this is a thing in some hotels. So, the job consists of people wearing a special sleeper suit and laying in bed in order to warm them up before the guests come to stay in the hotel. This practice has been used only in Holiday Inn hotels and is believed that people who sleep in warm beds have a better chance of getting a good night's sleep. I don't want a damn stranger sleeping in my bed right before I sleep in it. What if I'm just getting to the hotel and I'm not trying to sleep as soon as I get in? Do I gotta pay extra for this service? Do I gotta pay $19.99 to get my bed warmed when I could just go to the bathroom, take the hair dryer, and just warm the bed up myself like a normal person? No, some people wanna go the extra mile and have somebody sleep in their bed to warm it up. Ugh. But okay, it's a thing. Love bingo? Why not become a bingo manager for $56,000 a year? Hey, that doesn't seem too bad. If you love old ladies, and you love old ladies fighting, and you love bingo, perfect career path. You're welcome. I didn't even know this was a thing. Like, what's this dude do? Make sure Gertrude doesn't choke on her banana? Or Judith isn't snatching Barbara's weave? I don't even know. No snowflake in an avalanche ever feels responsible. Wow, what a message. Do you ever think of inspirational quotes like this one? Well, you could be a fortune cookie writer. They make $28,000 to $75,000 a year. For real? Okay. I didn't know this was an actual job. But you know, somebody has to do it. Somebody is writing all those fortunes. Oh, finally, a job for me. Y'all can't have it. This one's mine. I already put in my resume. I'm quitting YouTube to become a professional furniture tester. For $31,000 a year, you can sleep in beds, sit on couches for hours, and get paid for it. I mean, somebody's gotta do it. Somebody's gotta make sure the beds are comfy, the couches are soft, the pillows are squishy, the chairs are bouncy, and that person shall be moi. Leave a like if this is a job that you can finally do. All right, this one isn't as good, but you could be a pet food tester for $40,000 a year. No thanks, I'm going to have to pass. I mean, maybe you should get animals to be pet food testers. Not humans. Humans gonna eat it and be like, eh, this sucks. Disgusting. You got the texture all wrong. This doesn't taste like filet mignon. For real though, what good is a human testing pet food? All I can tell you is they're not doing a very good job because pet food does not taste very good to humans. So stupid. What are you doing, Janice? Does that chicken liver and gravy taste good, Janice? Does it? She don't even want to put it in her mouth. So how do you expect my dog to eat it? If you got at least a high school diploma and 7 years of horseback riding experience, you could make up to $50,000 as a horse rider slash exerciser. You'd be responsible for exercising and conditioning the horses for racing. Hey, that sounds like a pretty good job. You know, every school's got at least one of those girls that's like obsessed with horses, loves horseback riding, was very privileged as a child. Like, you can make a career out of it. And I love that. Like, making a career out of something you love doing. And I feel like everybody should try to do that. Whoa, okay, I didn't know this was a thing. This is wild. So golf ball divers can make up to $100,000 a year. So basically in those big golf courses, there's a lot of little bodies of water, little lakes or whatever, and golf balls, they sink. So they have to get an actual diver to like dive in the water and fetch all of those golf balls that found themselves in the water. But this is saying golf courses look harmless, but they're full of chemical-laced water, poisonous snakes, and snapping turtles. Oh my! I'm $100,000? Okay, let's go get some balls. That's what she said. Do you like being naked in front of your peers? Do you need money for school? Do you like busting it open for the sake of art? Say no more, I got the perfect job for you. Art models get paid $20 an hour for just sitting in a chair. And you know what? Most of the time, you don't even have to be naked. Obviously, for the nude models, they're gonna pay more, but sometimes they let you wear underwear, or you can even be fully clothed and just have art students draw what they see. I mean, if you that confident and you okay with that, that's easy money right there. All you gotta do is sit in a chair. I wonder how that works. Do you make eye contact with the people drawing you? Like, what's this girl looking at right now? It's funny how all these dudes are so preoccupied drawing her. They ain't nobody just like looking around or staring or whatever. Oh, but you know what? It's actually okay to stare in this case. I feel like this would be so awkward. Would you do this? Comment below. I don't know how safe this one is or how many people are hiring at the moment, but bum disposal divers spend a lot of time training and they can earn up to $100,000 a year depending on your rank in the armed forces. That is a very specific job. A bomb disposal diver. So are y'all getting rid of the bomb in the water or are you disarming bombs in the water? But if the bomb is already in the water, can't it just go off and we'd all be okay? See, that's what the training is for. Why do I have a feeling that these people spend most of the time doing nothing? No! One like equals $1 for this woman to collect this elephant's poop. I don't know how much she gets paid, but it's not enough. Love making someone's day. Hot dog vendors taking anywhere from $30,000 to $100,000 a year. What? So you telling me like in New York there's a ton of these like hot dog vendors all over the streets everywhere. You telling me they make $30,000 to $100,000? Okay, that's a big gap, you see. Which is it? But hey, that's pretty good money. Man, we got a job for everybody. Got a job if you like balls, golf balls. We got a job if you like hot dogs or watching people eat hot dogs, or you could become a water slide tester. Oh, this sounds bomb. It's only $30,000 a year, but you're gonna love your life. You're gonna love your job. You get to test water slides. I love water slides. And you get to test them for a job. I wonder if you have to be like all professional or you could just show up in your bathing suit and just keep going down it multiple times just to make sure it works. Does seem a little too good to be true. There's gotta be a catch. Shane Dawson gotta make a documentary on water slide testers. The things they don't tell you. Are you an amazing listener that loves everything about weddings? You could make $300 to $2,000 per wedding by being a professional bridesmaid. So you know, if the bride, she's lonely, she ain't got any good friends, or you know, you can't trust these hoes, they probably gonna end up stealing my man anyway. Just hire a professional bridesmaid. Okay, I mean, y'all got that much money to spare? Cool! Some people just love weddings. You get to have free cake, food, drinks, and a new best friend. I think that's a pretty win-win-win situation right here. Alright, this job isn't for everybody, but it's a job that's gotta be done. A crime scene cleaner makes about $50,000 a year. So if you love cleaning, especially blood, guts, and feces, this is the job for you. Nobody? Man, $50,000 a year? Hell no! Depends what side you working for. Oh, those dudes on John Wick, you know, if y'all have seen John Wick, they got like a cleaning crew. They pay them hella money to clean up all the dead bodies and stuff. They making a little more than $50,000 a year. That's if you work it for the cops. So this was actually on Dr. Phil. A woman was a professional snuggler, cuddler, whatever you want to call it. And this is great because anybody can do it. You just gotta love touching people or, you know, just snuggling with them. And you could get up to $60 an hour, which is pretty wild. Like, all you gotta do is nap with strangers. Big yikes. We love a risk. That's probably a bad idea. I don't know. I know there's like legit ways of doing this because it's actually a thing. You know, there's truly a job for everybody. On one site, there was somebody who reported being a toilet paper sniffer. You heard me right. They smell paper towels to make sure they are not too smelly in any fashion. So the range is $19,000 to $52,000 a year to sniff toilet paper. I mean, sign me up for this, me and my chronic stuffy nose. I mean, I'm already doing this every time I go to the bathroom, so. You're hired. These are such weird jobs, but you know, somebody has to do these things. Attention drama kids, you make $4,000 to $5,000 a month being an entertainer. Not that kind of entertainer, but specifically on a cruise ship. And there's a bunch of these jobs that you could do. So from voiceovers to acting to singing to dancing, and you get to travel the world, free cruises, and make $4,000 to $5,000 a month. Hell yeah! Hey, you, edgy 12-year-old boys. Yeah, you. Stop hacking Facebook and Twitter accounts. Become a certified ethical hacker. You can make like $70,000 a year, and they are in super high demand. So ethical hackers are basically professional hackers who are paid to hack computers and systems to find areas of weaknesses. Because big companies, they want to make sure that nobody can hack them. And how do they do that? By hiring hackers to try and hack them. So this is crazy. I know it's weird. You would never think a fisherman gets this much money, but specifically a crab fisher. It's a dirty job, and a single mistake can cost you your life. There's a lot of crazy conditions out there, so it's very dangerous. But you can earn hella good money. You can make up to $15,000 a month. Y'all heard me, a month. That's some fat money. But you know, crabs are expensive. Crabs go from like $20 to $50 a pound, sometimes even more. It's expensive. Okay, so I didn't know this was a real job. This is somebody I would actually hire, because I hate standing in line. I am the most impatient person you will ever meet. Like, if I ask someone to do something for me and I want it done right away and they don't do it right away, ooh, I'll just do it myself. Also, I love going to concerts, but I hate standing in line. So I would hire a professional queuer to stand in line for me. I know it's so extra, but this is an actual job. They get paid $36 per hour. It's a win-win situation. It's like you're getting paid to stand in line. Anyways, that's all for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Comment below and let me know what job you would choose. And make sure you hit that like button in the face. And make sure you subscribe, join the wolf pack. Oh, I love you guys so much. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.